an RC transmitter or radio control is the device you use to control your drone. Like your goggles, a transmitter can last for a while, so we recommend sparing as much of your budget for a transmitter as you can. Here are some of the features you should know about when selecting a transmitter. The majority of RC transmitters operate at 2.4 GHz, and that will suit most pilots and racing drones. It also allows for something called channel hopping, which helps reduce interference when multiple pilots are flying. However, there are also transmitters that operate at lower frequencies, such as 1.3 GHz, 900 MHz, and 433 MHz. The RC transmitter must be compatible with a radio receiver on the drone. Receivers operate using a certain protocol, and in some cases these can be brand specific, such as TBS Crossfire or FlySky, requiring you to use the matching transmitter. However, there are also receivers that use universal protocols such as SBUS, PWM, PCM, and PPM. Check to make sure the transmitter you're looking at supports the protocol of your quad's receiver. A popular option is to choose a good transmitter, then replace the receiver on the quad with one that matches. For maximum flexibility, some transmitters feature support for an external module, allowing you to operate using a different protocol or even a different frequency, such as 900 MHz. This allows you to operate multiple drones with different protocols simply by swapping modules on the transmitter. The number of channels the transmitter has will determine how much flexibility you have. Each channel is used to transmit a piece of information. We recommend a minimum of 6 for flying racing quads. You need 4 to control the quad: throttle, yaw, pitch, and roll. A 5th channel is typically used to arm and disarm the quad, and a 6th to change the flight mode. More channels will naturally allow you to add more features to your quad, such as the buzzer or RSSI telemetry data. While a drone can only be binded to a single transmitter, you can use one transmitter to control multiple drones. If you plan on assembling a small fleet, it is nice to have a transmitter that can store presets for all your different quads. Simply select your drone from the list and you're ready to go. Every transmitter is operated by built-in firmware, and OpenTX is something you may wish to consider. OpenTX is an open source firmware designed by pilots and is highly customizable. It is compatible with many popular transmitters, and some even come with it already installed. Making the right choice is more than just picking the features you want. Pay attention to the transmitter itself. If you can, try one out so you know how it feels in your hands. Pay attention to the size and weight and position of the controls and switches. Comfort is very important, as well as durability. This is your connection to your quad, and you want it to feel right. The types and quality of the gimbals has a profound effect on your comfort and control. Transmitters use two main types of gimbals, analog and digital. Traditional analog gimbals use potentiometers with brushes. Over time, these parts can wear out, especially on cheaper models. Hall sensor gimbals utilize magnets to measure the stick position. While pricier, they operate smoothly and precisely and are less prone to wearing out. The difference in quality between models and manufacturers can also be quite large. The quality of the components will not only affect the durability, but also the performance and feel. Like drones, transmitters are also customizable. Gimbals can be replaced in most transmitters, allowing you to start affordably with the option to upgrade the quality and type down the road. Better transmitters will naturally provide you with more features and options, such as telemetry warnings, external module support, and the ability to add an external antenna. For beginners and those on a tight budget, $50 to $60 can get you a solid transmitter with the basic features and minimum number of channels you'll need to get started. The quality and options open up in the $100 to $150 range, with more channels, flexibility, and the ability to save presets. The options from $200 and up will provide an ever-increasing number of channels, features, quality components, and the ability to swap RF modules. If you can afford it, a transmitter in this range will likely last you for many years. Have any questions about transmitters or anything else related to FPV or drone racing? Let us know in the comments. You can also visit the Drone Racing International FPV Facebook group to ask the members your questions or share your FPV video. Subscribe to our channel to see our weekly top 5 videos chosen from the members. Thanks for visiting Dronucopia, and happy flying.